Welcome. In this video, I'm going to create a chi-square test of independent solution for this 4x4 contingency table, and also create templates for conducting tests for tables of other dimensions. The null hypothesis for this test will be that the two variables are independent, and the alternative will be that they are dependent. I'll start by taking row totals. So equals sum for the first row, and drag the handle down for the others. Same for column totals. Equals sum for the first column, drag to the right for the rest. Next, I'm going to copy the observed table and paste for expected frequencies table here, and delete the observed frequencies. The expected frequencies can be calculated by taking row total times column total divided by overall total. So for the first cell, equals row total times column total divided by the overall total. Now, to ensure that I can drag that correctly to other cells, I need to log down some values. I'm going to double-click on the cell, type a dollar sign before F to log down the F column for row totals. Then type a dollar sign before 7 here to log down row 7 for the column totals. Then make F7 an absolute cell by pressing F4 or entering dollar signs before F and before 7. Enter and drag to the right. Then down for the other cells. I will double click on the cell to ensure that the correct cells are selected, and also check to ensure that the expected totals are the same as the observed totals. Next, I'm going to calculate the chi-square statistic using this formula. I'll copy the observed table without the totals and paste to the right here. Label it calculations and delete the frequencies. In the first cell, I'll select the first observed minus the first expected squared, and then divide by the first expected. Enter. Drag to the right, then down. The observed chi-square statistic, which I call chi-squared observed, is the sum of all these values. Now, in the spirit of setting up a template, I'll count the rows by selecting the first item of each of the rows. And for columns, count the number of items in the first row of the columns. The degrees of freedom for the test is number of rows minus 1 times number of columns minus 1. And let's suppose we have a significance level alpha of 0.05. I'm going to color the observed cells yellow and do the same for the alpha value. Those will indicate the only cells we need to change once the template is complete. I'm going to strategically leave the next two rows here blank. You'll see why later. I'll place the chi-squared critical value here. The function is chi-squared.inverse.righttail with inputs alpha, comma, degrees of freedom. Then enter. That is, if our test statistic is greater than 16.919, we will reject the null hypothesis. I'm going to place the observed chi-square statistic calculated earlier here. Since 14.5 is not greater than 16.9, we fail to reject the null hypothesis, and therefore cannot conclude that group and area are dependent. Next, we have the p-value, which is calculated using the chi-square distribution.righttail function. The inputs are chi-square statistic, comma, then degrees of freedom. Since the p-value is not less than alpha, again, we cannot reject the null hypothesis. We can also obtain the p-value directly from observed and expected frequencies by using a chi-squared.test function. We select the observed or actual values, comma, then the expected values. Enter. The template is now ready. I'm going to label the sheet 4x4 since we have 4 rows and 4 columns here. The purpose of creating templates is so that whenever I need to conduct any contingency table test, I will simply need to enter the observed frequencies here, change the significance level if necessary, and all calculations will be done automatically. Next, I'll create templates for a few other table dimensions. I'm going to duplicate this sheet by right-clicking on the Sheet tab, Move or Copy, check the Create a Copy box, click OK. I'm going to make this one a 4x3 template, that is 4 rows and 3 columns. So all I need to do is delete one column. I've set it off so that I can always delete either column 2 or 3 or row 2 or 3 or both without affecting any of the formulas. I'm going to delete the second column by right-clicking on column C and clicking Delete. I'll delete column I here as well. As you can see, we have 4 rows, 3 columns, 6 degrees of freedom, and everything else is calculated. Here again, we can't reject the null hypothesis because the test statistic is not greater than the critical value, or the p-value is not less than 0.05. I'm going to make a copy of this sheet too to create a 3x3 template. I can easily do it by deleting row 2 or row 3. I'm going to delete row 2 up here and delete it down here too. We now have a 3x3 template. Now, creating a copy for a 2x2, I'm going to delete the middle column here and here too. Then I'm going to delete the middle row up here and down here too. This result is statistically significant at alpha equals 0.05. In this case, we will reject the null hypothesis and conclude that the two variables are dependent. Now, suppose I want to extend the 4x4 table to, say, 4x5. I can insert a column between columns 2 and 3. Drag area 2 all the way to the end. I'll enter some values here. Drag to copy the sum formula. Copy the formula in column 2 to the rest. I'll do the same for the calculations table. Insert. Highlight the second column and copy that to the rest. We now have a significant result here after the update. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.